If you want to create a simple document from your Airtable data, then this video is for you. I'm going to be showing you a very simple, easy to follow example using just a couple of variables that we're going to put into a template and automatically create some documents inside of our Airtable database. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth Pronovost. I own Gap Consulting, and we are going to help you save up to 20 hours per week thanks to no code and automation. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, you don't want to miss my upcoming webinar. You can register to sign up for that at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. That webinar is going to teach you the fundamental building blocks of automation so that you can get well on your way to start saving time thanks to no-code tools like this. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video and talk about creating documents inside of our Airtable database using our Airtable data. Now, before I get going, I want to say that it is possible for you to use an Airtable app called the Page Designer. The Page Designer can be found inside of your apps. It requires that you're on a paid Airtable plan, and the Page Designer is great. You can install it right here, and it works wonders, but there are some limitations of the Page Designer. Namely, it is limited to whatever size page you create. So if you might have a document that goes multiple pages, Page Designer is probably not the best option for you. The other thing that the Page Designer does not do, it doesn't automatically create your documents. So the Page Designer is great because it can put your document out there, but you then have to go into the app and tell it to print your document or save it as a PDF. And, you know, let's face it, this is the world of automation. We want it fast, we want it now, and we don't want to have to do it manually. So let's look at one of my favorite tools, Documint. That's M-I-N-T. Documint is an awesome tool that allows us to actually build inside of their software whatever we want, and we can bring variables in to automatically create these documents based on the template that we create. Now, I've showcased some document in previous examples, but they've gone pretty deep. We did an invoice, for example, that, you know, it included multiple layers of tables and interactions. For this video, I want to keep it really simple so that you too can start putting something to work in Document. And I don't want you to have to worry about all the craziness of multiple layers of architecture. So we're keeping it really easy. Back in Airtable, all I have is one table. It's really simple. I have an account, I have a client, and I have a client email. And then the other piece I want is an open attachment field where I can bring back the document that I create. So this is all we're working with. I'm sure for your own needs, you're going to have different layers of variables and all of that. But I just want to keep it simple for this example with these three things: the account name, the client, and the client email. So let's pop in a document. And in fact, we're going to zoom back out and we're going to start at the beginning. And I don't want to start from a template. I'm going to start from scratch. So I have to first start and create this document. Now I'm going to keep it really simple and just bring in a text element. I'm going to drop it into my first column. I'll double click inside of here and I'll start typing. I'll say something like, this account belongs to, and here's where I want to bring in a variable, but I haven't yet assigned my variable, so let's do that. On the right-hand side of my screen, rather than just having the same account every time, I want to have something that updates depending on the account that lives inside of my Airtable database. So I have to create that variable. I click on new variable. Over here, it's going to say, do you want to enter in a standard variable or is it an Airtable variable? And this is why I love Document, because they built themselves specifically to help with Airtable and this document creation within Airtable data. And so, of course, we're going to click on Airtable because that's where our data lives. I go back in here and I'm going to copy the field name for account. Going back now to Document, I'm going to paste that in here. And you'll see that Document automatically converts that to whatever the document standard, you know, template for that particular variable name is going to be. So I click to copy, and then I can then drop that back into my text and just paste it. So these double squirrely brackets that say account, that is going to be updated with whatever the account is that lives in my Airtable field. Let's move on. I'm going to say, and the client is. And now I want to bring in the client name. Similarly, I'm going to create a new variable. It's an Airtable variable. So I flip back to Airtable and I copy and paste this client name, and I go back to Document, paste it in there, and you're probably starting to see a pattern. Double squiggly brackets, lowercase letters, that's what we're working with here. Now things are gonna change when I get into this last one because I'm referencing client email. So now, last time, again, I'm gonna add a new variable. This time it's gonna be the client email going back to my document. Now the difference here is my client email variable or field has multiple capital letters and a space. So when we bring it into Document and we paste it in here, you're gonna see that those spaces get converted to underscores and all capital letters are brought down to lowercase. That's it, I'm gonna copy, I'm gonna drop in here one more time in my template, paste it in, and I'm good to go. Now, I can adjust the way that this text is showing up. Let's go ahead and select it. I can make it larger. I can delete this column if I want this to take up the entire place. And of course, I can have a lot of other information in my template. Maybe I use a lot of static stuff. If this is a work agreement or some sort of contract, something along those lines, I'm gonna have some standard text in here that doesn't change every time. So whatever is not surrounded in those squirrely brackets is the same every time. And it's those squirrely brackets that are gonna bring in variables that changes every time based on Airtable data. All right, we are good now. We have this set up. Let's preview what this would look like. Another cool feature of Document, flipping into my preview, I can see exactly what my document is gonna look like, and I have my variables listed over here on the side, and I can simply name them. I can say this account is Gap Consulting. The client is Gareth. And the client email is here. And once I fill this information out, we see that Document takes a minute to think, and it fills out our document perfectly. So now we have a working template that is accepting our variables, but it's time to build an automation so that this thing works on its own. Now in a previous video, I showcased how you can do this using Document's scripting function within Airtable, building a direct integration to Airtable thanks to a script. But this is a pro feature that requires that you're on a paid plan with Document. And if you're just starting out and if you're brand new to the tool, you probably don't want to invest money in it until you're at the point where you realize the true value and you've tested it out. So in order to get functionality for this example, let's build an automation using a third-party tool. In this case, I will use Zapier. So let's go ahead back to our design here, and I am going to tap in the upper corner and select integrations. You'll see that I have Integromat on the way. Also, if you build portals inside of Stacker, you can also create documents from button pushes inside of Stacker, as well as Airtable. But for our example here, I'm gonna use Zapier. So let's go ahead and make that selection. And here's what we're gonna do. Zapier shows us an example workflow: collect data, create the document, store the document. This is just an example, no problem. We are gonna move on with this. So let's pop into our Airtable base first, and I'm gonna create a button that allows us to create our document using a button field here. And inside of our button, it takes generally a URL, although it could perform some other actions as well, like run scripts, etc. In this case though, I'll keep it with URL, and I am going to actually use a webhook in order to trigger this. Now I'm going to put a placeholder in here for now, and I'll come back once I have created my webhook so that I can just pop it in here. And then when we push the button, it will trigger that webhook, and that will perform our automation. So popping into Zapier, first thing I need to do is create a zap, not too difficult here. And I am going to use a webhook, which you see here. This is a premium feature of Zapier, so you will need to be on a paid Zapier plan. I will make that selection, and I'm going to use a catch hook, continue from here. And this is the webhook URL. Now I'm going to pop back into Airtable and actually put that information right here in my button. But this by itself is not quite enough. I want to add to this and append it with our record ID, because every time the button is pushed, it needs to be assigned to a specific record in Airtable, not just any old button push, right? The webhook has to receive information that's relevant to this particular record. So let's do that. I'm gonna go ahead and add this, start with a concatenate formula, and then after this, I'm going to say record ID equals, and I'm gonna call the record ID from Airtable. So now when I push this webhook, it will open up, but not only is it using the webhook URL, it's also passing along the record ID, which I can now use in the next steps of my automation. Let's close this out, go back to Zapier, and I test this webhook, and it tells me, yes, in fact, the webhook did trigger, and here's the record ID that was passed along. See that this is the name that we assigned to it, and this is the variable that filled out for that particular record ID. Now that that's done, we can find that record in Airtable. So I will go back into my Airtable app and I will look up the record that has that record ID. But that record ID doesn't actually show up in our data anywhere, so I better bring it in. Here is my record ID, and I'll use a formula here. Calling the record ID, again, that's the same record ID formula that we used just in our past formula. I'm going to create this record, and that record ID is completely unique for every record in our database. So back in Zapier, I'm going to find that record in my Airtable database, choose the account, and of course, we need to tell it what base it lives in. In this case, ours is called Simple Doc. Once we have that, we only have the one table to choose from, and we're going to use the record ID field that we just created, and we're looking for a match with the record ID that we received in our webhook trigger. Now, let's go ahead and test this. Click continue and test and review, and it should give us the green checkbox that says, yes, Zap search was found, status equals true, meaning I found a record that matches that ID, and here's everything you want to know about that record. That's the account name, that's the client name, and that's the client email. So far, so good. We have all the information in our automation now that we require in order to do the final step, which is actually create the document. So let's go into Documint in beta presently. I make that selection. I choose an event. I want to create a document. I'm going to go ahead and continue. And I have to choose my template ID. These are the different templates that it was able to find. I have two that are named blank, so I better go back to Document again and properly name this new template that I've created. Clicking in, I'll just rename it Example, and I'll go back to Zapier. I will refresh my fields, and I will load more here, and there we see that this has been named Example. I make that selection, and I have to tell it what this information is. These are the three variables I have in Document. Let's map to them. So, of course, we found this record in Airtable. The account name is Fields Account. The client name, let's expand that again and go to All Options. Client name is Fields Client. And then lastly, I have client email inside of my Airtable base as well, and it's right here. So we can go ahead and continue from here, and we will go ahead and test and review. And of course, this should give us the green checkbox that yes, in fact, a document was created, but now what are we gonna do with it? Well, this URL right here is the document, and we have a short period of time in which we can actually access that and do something with it. So now for one more final step, let's choose to update our Airtable record with the document that we just created. I'm going to update a record in Airtable. Let's continue. Again, we have to choose our proper account and, of course, link it to our correct database. In this case, it's called Simple Doc. And I will choose my proper table as well, which is table 1. And what record am I updating? Well, that is the record that we found in the second step, right? So I can just plug that record ID in right here. And now I'm going to update the record that triggered this whole automation. And what I want to update, of course, is my document field. I want to bring in that document URL, and we can find it right here, document URL that came from our third step. I plug it in. Let's go ahead and test this step and go back to our Airtable base. We see that something was just uploaded, and if we click on it, hopefully we see the right document. So there you go, folks. This is all possible with a free Documint account. It does require a paid Zapier plan because, as I mentioned, webhooks are an advanced feature. I prefer webhooks for triggering automation if it requires a button push because it's a faster, more efficient way to do it. But you can still get the same results even if you don't use a webhook trigger if you build a similar but different trigger in your automation. I hope this gave you a ton to consider and that you check out Documint as a possibility for automating your document creation. If you do want to give them a shot, please consider using my referral link that I'll include below. It's a nice way for you to give some love back to the channel, and I will see you in our next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.